Ryan, will Peyton Krebs' partial Achilles tear cause him to fall a bit in the draft?
You know what? I don't think it will, based on when it happened. If this had happened early in the season, then maybe some teams would have been a little more reticent. But because everybody knows what Peyton Krebs is capable of, you've got that body of work to investigate. And, you know, he was also good at the World Under 18s for Canada. I think that really helps, where you just know that when you pick him now, he's not going to go right to the NHL. You know, obviously that expectation is out the window now. It's never good when a player that young misses development time, but Peyton Krebs has been in the WHL for a while now. Mm-hmm. You know, he was a number one overall Bantam pick with the Kootenay Ice. They're now moving to be the Winnipeg Ice. And if anything, I feel sorry for the Winnipeg Ice, because they really needed him if they were going to make any sort of progress this season. So that's tough for them. But I think whoever selects him in the NHL draft is going to say, okay, well, we know what he's all about. It's going to take a bit of extra time. We'll keep monitoring him when he gets back to junior. And you know, what you're left with is a very smart guy with a great tool set who has thrived under adversity on some pretty poor ice teams in the WHL. And yeah, it's unfortunate they got hurt, but you know, he's still a pretty good prospect.
I always feel like it's a short-sighted notion that teams would pass, or I mean, maybe it's just a thought by a team, that a team would ever pass on a guy based on, I mean, not that an Achilles tear is a minor injury, but right, like a kid like Krebs, he's gonna bounce back and he's gonna be a hell of an NHLer. I mean, and pass on him, you know, would be silly to me.
I would think so. And, you know, an example I would give is Tyler Benson, who had a great year with the Bakersfield Condors. He's an Edmonton Oilers prospect. He missed a ton of time in junior with a couple of different injuries, and it really seemed like he was snake bitten. And, you know, it affected his development. It took him a bit longer. But once he got to the AHL, you know, once he got those reps, he was really good. And again, that was a player who was a really high pick in the WHL draft, came in highly acclaimed. There was a lot of hype. And were it not for the injuries, he probably would have put up huge numbers. As it was, you know, he was a good player. And now he's showing what his pedigree was all about. It was just like, yeah, as soon as he gets healthy and, you know, gets his legs under him, he should be good to go. And Tyler Benson demonstrated that this year.